they came together in mourning and prayer. The people of the Cowessess First Nation hosting a gravesite vigil Saturday, open to anyone who wanted to come and honor those found in as many as 751 unmarked graves near the former site of the Maryvale Residential School.
We had a lot of support from all the communities around the area here because they all have loved ones here.
The unmarked graves now identified by not only a flag, but a small solar light. Not everyone found buried here went to the residential school, but some did. Finding these children at last has come as a relief to some.
Definitely grief that goes along with what's been found out, but there's also a sense of relief because we've been talking about this, our community, our people, our elders have been talking about this for many years. It's been hidden for so long.
At 7:51, mourners marked a moment of silence before residential school survivors shared stories of a past filled with pain.
It was so important. It was important for me to be with my community, with my leadership, and take part in the process of honoring, you know, the children that went through residential school.
It has been an emotionally difficult few days for many families here, but the work is not done yet.
The next steps is to continue on with the survey to make sure that we don't have any that we missed, and to put markings on the unmarked graves and have a name to them.
To do that, Cowessess First Nation is hoping to obtain historical documents from the Catholic Church. Across the country, Catholic and other Christian churches are facing mounting community anger over their role in the operation of residential schools. In BC, a fifth church, the St. Paul's Anglican Church on the Gitwengak First Nation, was set ablaze. This time the flames were extinguished before the building was lost.
While I understand that hostility and needing to find a way to heal from it, that church was built by our ancestors in the late 1800s, by the hands of our elders at the time with such a great sense of pride.
In Edmonton, police are investigating after a statue of Pope John Paul II was vandalized with red paint.
But after the discovery of 215 unmarked graves in Kamloops, BC, and as many as 751 in Saskatchewan, emotions are running high.
Sunday marks the fourth day since the discovery here was announced. The day began with a traditional pipe ceremony at the site. A community feast is also planned. It's a ceremonial practice believed to help the spirits continue on to the spiritual world. Robin?
Heather Yerkes West near the Cowessess First Nation in Saskatchewan. There is some support for those who need it. The Indian Residential School Survivors Crisis Line is confidential and available 24 hours a day. The toll-free number is 1-866-925-4419.